Hello everyone, I wanted to clear a few things up about inter-blockchain communication. There's been a lot of questions asked around and I want to clarify a few things, especially regarding the mainnet or a mainnet. Some people have been debating about that word. So I want to explain how inter-blockchain communication works and how it can interact with side chains. Okay, so let's imagine we launch a mainnet which has the ERC20 tokens. So a lot of people have a lot of tokens on there. And someone launches another sidechain which does not have the snapshot, right? There's no money issued over there. And then what we could do is with a pair of contracts, let's call that one here the source network, okay, where all the money is. And we'll call that one the sidechain. And with the contract in here and in here, you're able to send money to the contract in here. So the money's gonna be sort of locked into that contract. Right? The contract will not spend it. It'll keep it there. And with the proof of that transaction, you can bring it on the other chain. And the other chain has a paired contract, right? It knows that it's coming from over there. And it's going to honor a transaction and recognize this was really a transaction that happened on the source network. I'm going to take that transaction. And then you have all the information to unpack it. So you know the source and destination, you know the amount of EOS that was transferred to that account or even other currencies. And the contract can do many things. It could say, I'm going to also give you or print that contract with print EOS, and then you could transfer it to some other place, right? And you could start using that money over there. But if you want to go back to the main network or the source network, you need to go back through the same contract saying, okay, I'm now going to burn those tokens. So the contract will give you a proof that it has burnt the token, destroyed them, and you're going to bring that proof to the other smart contract. And the other smart contract has the block headers. They're constantly exchanging through some third party or like putting in there the block headers from one of the other chain, and that one will be able to say, okay, you really destroyed the tokens on the other chain, I'm going to give you back those EOS that are locked in the contract. So there's only one monetary base. Eventually block producers could be, you know, producing blocks for the whole ecosystem for many side chains if it starts being worth it, but there would not be inflation on that other chain, right? Because it doesn't control the monetary base, only the source chain would. So perhaps the block producer would be rewarded because the EOS ecosystem is growing and growing also in number of chains. So that would still mean that you need to run servers to support the other chains, but I think that would make sense to have I'll be paid off by, you know, those who are running the main chain or the source network where the EOS token is reigns supreme, right? If you have any questions, put that in the comment. Join us our channel on EOS Canada. We'll have a link in the description. And click subscribe, click like, da 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 da. We'll see you next time. Bye.